Well, for a deeper look at the launch of the standard gauge railway, I spoke more to investment expert Ali Khan Sachu, who you just saw in that report. He's CEO of Rich Management Limited. And I started by asking him about the potential economic impact of Kenya's biggest infrastructure project since 1963.
The first thing to note is Kenya is the transit state for this region. It is the route to the sea, not only for ourselves, but for a number of adjacent countries. And if Kenya wants to preserve that transit state status, which is very valuable, it's got to be putting in first-class infrastructure. And I think this the railway, more than 120 years after the Lunatic Express and 5 centuries after the first engagement between China and Kenya under the eunuch Muslim Admiral Zheng He, this is a significant investment and cements Kenya's position as the transit state on the eastern side of the continent.
How key of a role will this project play in terms of China's broader Belt and Road Initiative?
Well, it's interesting, isn't it? I was looking at the map again, and obviously we're on the periphery of that One Belt, One Road vision that President Xi Jinping has. But definitely Kenya is, and this railway is a part of that puzzle. And the importance cannot be gainsaid, and that's why China wrote a check of almost $4 billion to get this off the ground.
Now, in terms of the sectors that could really benefit from this, obviously this is a huge infrastructure undertaking. What are some of the other sectors that are also benefiting from this?
You know, Justin Lin, who was the head of, was the World Bank chief economist for a long time, is now back in China, has estimated there are about 100 million jobs, low-cost manufacturing jobs, that need to be transferred out of China. And I think this railway puts us in a position to try and grab some of that transfer and be a beneficiary of it, because it allows people to come set up manufacturing businesses along the railway line in Kenya, basically to tap into a huge amount of cheap geothermal power and then send these goods to the global market, the Indian Ocean, the wider Indian Ocean. That's a 3 billion people market if you take the whole sweep up to China. So definitely, I think it's going to have it's going to be a big catalyst. It's going to make people sit up and think, hang on a second, that looks like an interesting destination to put our factories and to do that kind of thing. And I think that is really going to be beneficial.
So if you're a business and you're seeing all this investment going into this project, strategy-wise, what should businesses be really doing to capitalize on this?
So I think you've got to be close to the railway if you're a business. You've got to look to tap into some of this geothermal energy, which is very, very inexpensive and which we have tremendous resources. So you've got the power, you've got the railway to take you to a massive global market. And I think what we're going to see is a lot of people looking to exploit that opportunity. What sort of businesses? I mean, you know, one can imagine apparel manufacturers. We've seen a lot of progress in that space.
And for everyday people who are watching this wondering, how do I reap the benefits of this? How soon do you think the economic benefits will really trickle down to everyday people?
That's an interesting question. I think we're going to see that happen pretty quickly. Just from a transport point of view, individuals can now travel to Mombasa in 4.5 hours for $9 economy class. That's very reasonable. It's putting you, you know, it's allowing you to go to the second biggest city in Kenya very quickly. I think that will be transformative. It's going to take a lot of business off the roads. And I think the average person is going to find it much easier and cheaper to do business. And, you know, Africans and Kenyans included are very entrepreneurial. And one of the biggest challenges has been transport costs, the ease of doing business. This is going to ease business tremendously along what is a vital corridor, not only for Kenya, but for, you know, Uganda, for the DRC even, and for many others. So I expect this is going to be a catalyst for economic activity, probably add on about 1.5% to GDP going forward. And I think that's going to be meaningful. And I think the average person will feel those benefits. The excitement we've seen with the launch today by the president of the cargo trade speaks to that kind of sense that, you know, the country is leapfrogging, it's making progress, and that, you know, the railway is like the plumbing of any economy. And I think in Kenya's case, because of that transit state status I was talking about, we've got to have good plumbing. And I think that's what we're seeing here.